According to the problem description in this lab, we need to manipulate data coming from measurement instruments through calculations. Once we do that, we are going to store that data in the PI server so that everybody will have access to the same results, the same data. In order to perform our calculations, we will be using different frequencies of calculation or scan classes, and we want to make sure that those scan classes are available on our server. In order to check for that, I'm going to go to the PI bin directory under the C drive, where I'm going to find the, let me go ahead and expand this. Pipe scheduler.bat. I'm going to right click and edit that file to take a look and see what scan classes are available. The scan classes are shown here in the last line. We can see that there are three different scan classes. The first one, which has a frequency of 1 minute. The second has a frequency of 2 minutes, and the last one has a frequency of 30 seconds. All of them will calculate the performance equation on the hour because the offset is zero. Now that we know that these scan classes are available, let's go ahead and go to the system management tools and create the performance equations. In here, we are going to go to points and performance equations. We click on new, and we can go ahead and enter the information as it was provided in the lab manual. The name of this first performance equation is going to be CDT158.average. The description is going to be the average of CDT 158 over 2 minute periods, and that's the frequency at which we are going to compute this calculation. Next, we want to make sure that we have a float 32 point, that the point source is C, that the engineering units are in degrees Celsius, and now we are ready to move on to the next tab, the equation, where we can go ahead and enter our PI equation of tag average in between parentheses CDT 158 between single quotes, and we are going to calculate the average of that tag in between the times of 2 minutes ago, so that's now minus 2 minutes and now, so the time period is a 2 minute time period. Next, we can go to the scheduling tab, and in here we want to set this up for scan class number 2. As it was mentioned before, we have three scan classes available. The scan class 2, as you remember, was the one with a 2 minute frequency. We go to the archive tab, and in here we want to make sure that the zero value is going to be zero, that the span is going to be 150, and that our typical value is 50. We also want to ensure, according to the directions, that compression is on and that the exception deviation is zero and the compression deviation is zero. At this point, we are ready to save this performance equation, so we can click on the save icon. And at the bottom, we can see the log that says that the performance equation was successfully created. Now we can go ahead and create the next performance equation by clicking on New. Going to the General tab, we are going to enter the name now of BA. Oops, sorry. Status dot one, and the description of this performance equation is going to be the status of the batch reactor. Again, we want to make sure that the point type is string in accordance to the directions, that the point source is C. The engineering units, we are going to leave that portion blank, and the equation that we are going to enter is provided in our manual. We are going to concatenate the digital text from between single quotes CDM 158 and the text of space and the tag BA phase dot one, again in between single quotes. We go to the scheduling tab and we are going to schedule this as a event-based scheduling, with the event tag being the BA phase dot one tag. Under scheduling also, we want to make sure that the timestamp of the resulting expression is set to the time when the expression is evaluated. This can also be checked under classic. Location 3 is 0. So we are now ready to save our performance equation. We check our logs and we ensure that the logs state that the performance equation was successfully created. And now we click on New Performance Equation for our last one, which is going to be the BA ethylene volume. The description is going to be the volume of ethylene produced by the minute. The engineering units are going to be cubic meters. We want to ensure that the point type is float 32, that the point source is C, and under equation we can go ahead and create our equation, which according to the manual, and let me go back and look at the equation that is provided for us here, as explained in the manual. This is the, let me see, it's down here. As we can see, we are going to use the ideal gas law, and we have inserted some constants into this equation, and that's what we are going to type in here for an equation. So for CDP 158, we are going to times that 8.314472, and that's going to be times CDT 158 plus 273.15 divided by 28.05 times 200. Next, we go to scheduling. We want to make sure that the scan class is 1. For a 1 minute scan frequency, we go to archive and we want to ensure that the zero values at zero, the span is set to 300 and our typical value is 50. We also want to use an exception deviation of 0.1 and a compression deviation of 0.2. Now that we completed these equations, we can go ahead and save the performance equation, and we can see that it was successfully created. Now, an easy way to check on these performance equations and ensure that they are actually calculating the data and producing data is by going to the archive editor under data and performing a search for the performance equations that we created. They all had a point source of C, so point source of C, we do the search, and at the bottom of the list we can see the three performance equations that we created. CDT 158 average, let's double click on that, and we can see that it has been calculating the average value every 2 minutes. We can go back to our search and check on the BA status, which is the batch reactor. We still don't have any data there. Let's go ahead and check on the last one, which is the volume of ethylene produced, and still don't have any data on either one. Let's go back and make sure that our performance equations have no errors in them by going to points, point builder. We can do a search for our tags in here, and the tags, the BA status. We can check on the equation, make sure that we type that in a correct format, which is the concatenation of the digital text of CDM 158 plus the A space and BA or batch, the reactor phase 1. Let's go back to the archive editor and see if we have any data so far. We can see that our ethylene volume performance equation has already started producing some data. And let's make sure that we also have data for the status of the batch reactor, and we have data.